Okay, that was a nasty hit. Turn the engine off and wait for the marshals. Hello and welcome to the Isle Notre Dame once again for what promises to be another incredible Canadian Grand Prix at this fiercely competitive circuit, where pole position can often be decided by less than a tenth of a second. If you want flat-out racing, you've come to the right place this weekend, as it's full throttle for 59% of this 2.7-mile circuit, peaking at around 210 miles per hour going into the final chicane. But that speed requires discipline, and there are more than a few close walls here just waiting to punish drivers with a heavy right foot. Let's run you through the driver grid order for today's exciting race. It's Carlos Sainz in pole position, edging out Lando Norris, who'll start from P2. As we continue through the rest of the grid today, we have Ricciardo, Verstappen, Sergio Perez, and Magnussen, Russell, Ocon, Hamilton, and Valtteri Bottas, Leclerc, Mick Schumacher, Guan Yu Zhou, and Tsunoda, Albon, Gasly, Sebastian Vettel, and Lance Stroll, Latifi, and more. And now it's time to head down to the track. Alongside me to discuss all the action today is Natalie Pinkham. Thanks for joining us, Natalie. And tell me, you were down in the pit lane earlier. How do you think the track conditions are today?
Well, the surface looks clean enough, but I'm a little bit worried about the track temperature. It's pretty cool out there, which could give some teams difficulties when it comes to keeping their tyres in the right operating window. The cars out there that work their tyres hard and really put a lot of energy through them, well, they'll be the ones that are better off.
Okay, now that we've got some good points on the board, let's continue this form and aim for another top 10 finish. Okay, so everything looks good on the power unit cycles, so let's concentrate on bringing tyres and brakes up to temperature. Overheating the engine will exacerbate the issue, so keep temps under control, please.
Well done, good finish. You stepped up and achieved what we asked. Good job.
What a fantastic Grand Prix that was. And an excellent win for McLaren. Natalie Pinkham, how do you think they were able to set themselves apart today?
Well, they certainly stood out as a driver with tons of confidence on the track. I think their ability to keep their cool, even during some of the more hectic parts of the race, meant they were able to capitalise on the mistakes of other drivers, giving them the opportunity to make their way to the top spot with ease.
Our drivers are making their way out for the podium celebrations, and it's going to be McLaren picking up the winner's trophy. Congratulations to the entire team for that fantastic performance. Let's have a look then at the driver's standings. Moore increases their championship lead. So then, Natalie Pinkham, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
I have to give it to Moore. Look at where they finished compared to where they started. It's not easy to cut through a field like that in Formula One, so it was a great effort.
It's time to check out the constructors' standings. McLaren supplant the previous leaders and take control of the championship. It was also a strong Grand Prix from Haas F1 this weekend. Fantastic work from the American team to move themselves further up the table. Well, what an end to another fantastic weekend.
See as your rival. We need your input. Thanks. I appreciate you taking the time to help out. We had a major issue on the production line earlier this week, so the entire development package for this weekend has failed. Any redevelopments will need to be ordered from the R&D screen. Our new parts have completed without issue. They'll be on the car ready for the next race weekend.